Hello, everybody. Jim here. And today I want to talk about the graphical settings I use and a third-party resource called Reshade and that I use to make the game look better. It's pretty simple stuff. I'm just going to go over the settings, what they do, and why they impact your performance. And hopefully, you guys learn a little bit from this video. If you do, give it a like. If you have any questions, of course, put it in the comments below. And let's start with the options. Windowed full screen. Frame limiter, I actually usually keep it at 60. But I have it set to unlimited just for this video sake, right? When it comes to MMORPGs, honestly, having over 60 FPS isn't a big deal for me personally. It does feel smoother, but it's not as drastic as playing a shooter. So I don't really worry about it. 60 is fine. Animations set to high. This just makes everything look smooth. As far as when it comes to character animations, as you know, when it comes to spells and things like that, it makes it look flashy, nice. Just basic movement, things like that, looks good. Anti-aliasing, of course, it makes the jagged edges go away. We want to set this to high as well. Environment set to high so the world can look as detailed as it can. LOA distance. This is mainly just when it comes to loading things from a distance. Things like textures, maybe animals, NPCs, things of that nature. I set that to ultra just because I want to see far ahead of me. When it comes to reflection, set this to none. Because underneath the ground, underneath all of Tyria, is water. It is a huge lake of water. Now, I was told this before, and I gotta be honest, I was like, I don't know about that. I was skeptical. But earlier ago today, actually, I glitched underneath the ground on accident, and nope, I was in water, and it was just a big lake. All of underneath Tyria is water, and when you have reflections affects the water, where you can see the sky, or sometimes you can see yourself depending on what you have it set at. So when you have all the water, including the water underneath Tyria, with reflections enabled, that tanks your frames. If you're having frame rate issues, disabling that can be the make or break. Alright, so next, textures high, render sampling native. Shadows is another really big deal. You can turn this off and gain some extra frames as well. It really depends on how many shadows are around you. Ultimately, shadows I have it set to medium because that's when things are becoming more refined. Low, as you can see, there's no shadows underneath me at the moment. There is a little bit there, but a lot of shadows are just blurry. And at that point, I would just want to turn them off, right? So I have these set to medium just so I can get a little bit of, and when you set it to high and then ultra, it just gets a little bit more sharper. A little bit more detailed. Medium, honestly, is just a happy balance. Post-processing, none. Right now, honestly, post-processing doesn't look too terribly bad, but when you get into really bright areas, the bloom is way too strong and it looks horrible. Like, let's go over here. Look at how bad that is up here. It's just the post-processing in this game is ugh. Nope. Next, character model limit and model quality. This is the probably one of the biggest things you can change. You don't really notice it unless there's a lot of people around you. But when you go into like big cities or you do huge, group content type things, the model limit and quality will be a huge factor when it comes to frame rate. Okay, next is ambient occlusion. This just adds a little bit more detail to the ground. So yeah, it's like some shadows and stuff. I like having it on personally. Yeah, it's you know, if you're wanting some extra frames, of course turning this off will help, but I like having it on. Texture filtering, of course, just makes things look a little bit more, detailed. Depth of blur just blurs things at a distance. I honestly don't like it. Can't really tell here, but there are certain areas that it just looks horrible. Effect LED, once again, this is limit detail particle effects. This is, once again, at a distance. I just have this enabled. It's fine, honestly. I don't really notice a difference with it on or off. High resolution character textures. This just makes like things like NPCs look a little bit more cleaner, look a little bit nicer. So I've got that enabled. There was a guy walking around here somewhere. I was trying to figure out where he went. Light adaptation. You have to turn this thing on best performance and then go around and tweak it just to get this enabled. Because if you put it on, or not best performance, I'm sorry, best appearance. If you put on best performance, it'll actually turn that off. All right. And then VSync, we have that off. And then motion blur, we have that off as well. When it comes to DirectX rendering beta, I have that checked. And from I've tried on a few different computers, and from what I could tell, is it actually kind of lowers the overall frame rate, but it raises the frame floor. So it makes the frame rate a lot more consistent. There's less, it doesn't drop as low, and honestly, I kind of like it. All right, now when it comes to reshade. Radiant GI, it pretty much replaces Bloom. It makes lights radiate, hence the name. Bloom, even in reshade Bloom, looks absolutely horrible. Looks the same as what Guild Wars 2 does. I don't know what it is with this game, but Bloom is... Radiant is what you're going to want to replace your Bloom with. This makes the lights flicker a lot more. Can't really tell a whole lot here because there's not like a lot of lights. But when you're like in a dungeon and stuff, Radiant really changes those torches, make them look a lot more lively. Now, HDR, I had to turn this down a little bit. It just, as you can see, it makes the colors pop a little bit more, makes the darkers more dark, the blacks more black. Though this, at default, it makes things look a little bit too dark, and when you're in really dark locations, it makes things hard to see. So I have HDR on, I just have it toned down just a little bit. Clarity, of course, just makes things a little bit more clear. This kind of, it doesn't take away the fog, but as you can see, it just makes things a little bit easier to see at a distance. It's the best that we can work with right now. I really wish they would take away the fog, but it's not much you can do about it. And then levels adds just a little bit more detail, a little bit more contrast in between the colors. As you can see, like the greens are darker now, right? It looks so much better. It just looks so much better. And then, of course, with this on, it looks gorgeous. Turn it off, it looks bland, it looks gray, it looks boring, it looks ugly. But look at that. The reds are popping. Oh, gosh, it looks so good. This is by no means like a realistic reshade. It just makes the colors look a lot more vibrant. And honestly, it just looks so much better, right? The grass is green. These guys hurt my friends, so we're going to avenge our buddies. There's another one right here. Oh, that was an event. But yeah, that's pretty much it when it comes to the settings, the reshade, things of that nature. I didn't really want to make a super long video, yeah. If you liked the video, give it a like. Like I said, if you have any questions or any concerns or anything like that, put it in the comments below. I do plan on releasing more content when it comes to Guild Wars 2. If you have any suggestions, please let me know. And I will see you guys in the next one.